Yo.
What is up, sucker mother lovers? I know it's been a long time since I did a review, but here I am. I ain't really like that one. Oh well, I'm not about to edit that. How y'all doing, sucker mother lovers? I had to sit my happy ass down because y'all know I be talking a little bit too much. Like when I get up, I have all that energy. And y'all know I don't need no extra energy. So I was like, let me sit my ass down somewhere. I know it's been a long time since I did a review. The reason being, like I told you guys before, I had that tea about Chris and I couldn't spill that tea, and I know how I am. I like sometimes let that cup spill it over, you know, and because I actually have a friend, I couldn't do it. So now that that tea is out, I can blab and talk as much as I want. So goddamn, here I am. First and foremost, let's get into the fact that Scrap Deleon is on the show. Now, I immediately, before I knew who Scrap Deleon was, I was like, so there's two Scraps? I'm sorry, because a couple times I heard people saying Lil Scrappy. So I'm like, wait, are we talking about Shiz Naeem Lil Scrappy, or is it somebody else that I don't know? Then I was like, oh, this long hair don't care. Lil Mufasa looking Scrap Deleon, Scrappy, Lil Scrap, 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 Scrappy, doop, doop, doop. Guy that came on the show, so I had to go and do a little Googling. Upon my Googling, I realized that Scrap Deleon is Scrap Deleon because he too used to be Lil Scrappy, and Lil Scrappy was like,
hey, bro, I'm about to put these paws on you if you don't get rid of my name, bro. Like, give me my name, man.
Like, so then Lil Scrap Jr. had to become Scrap Deleon, hence Scrap, Scrap, too many damn Scraps. They finna scrap over the name. So last episode, he called himself trying to be Stevie J Jr. You are not Stevie. So you sitting up here trying to sit down Tierra, your baby mama, and Tommy, old crazy ass, and thinking that you about to get some kind of results of making them ladies think that they gonna do what you need them to do while you go to jail, you got another thing coming. You gonna put the pipe down a little bit longer and really make these ladies think that they ain't got nothing to lose, cause you and your perm hair or your pressed Rashida, hey girl, like, no, you ain't got it. But I mean, them women actually went a freaking nuts. And isn't me, does Tommy kind of hold her mouth weird, like real, like gangster, like she does this thing with her mouth, like, yo, back up, son, back up. And it's like, damn, bitch. And though she got like 88 mug shots, I was like, girl, you look different, girl. You have been on the rough edges a couple of times, bitch. Now, call me a pervert, but I was doing this for researching purposes. But last episode, when they were showing Tommy walking up to the meeting with Tierra and Scrap Deleon, I noticed, I was like, are those nude shorts she got on, them nude pants? Like, what's missing? And I then realized that this was a dress that had the split that went up to her bra, and that if she walked a little bit too fast, all her vajayjay was gonna be out. And I'm not gonna lie, I rewinded it to make sure that I wasn't tripping, that I saw what I saw when I seen what I saw. And I did, and I was like, huh. So just, how you twat just out like that, you sneeze and just vagina hair just everywhere, huh? That's what you gonna do, huh? Because once wasn't enough for you to have your vajayjay all up in the camera when you was fighting, when you was fighting Tierra in the first place, huh? Okay. So you just one of them ladies just like you twat, just all. I mean, I ain't gonna judge you. You got enough mug shots, trust and believe. God know my levels, honey. I'm chilling. Child, Playboy done got messy ass Carly the model. She got all them damn cakes out, the silicone ones, the real ones, and everything in between. But I ain't mad at her ass because I'm like, ain't she like 58 years old? Like, I'm like, if Playboy asked me to do something, I'm over the age of 50, bow. You can see all this little B. It's, I mean, we are BBs. We are barely Bs, but we here, goddamn it, we here to stay. But I was like, goddamn, Carly's so messy. And then she got life. Every time I listen to Life Talk, I think of him and DMX, and I automatically assume that those two just really, really, really would make me happy if they both just drank a whole bottle of lotion. Their voices sound so graspy and just ashy, where I'm like, just a little moisture just to go down there, because their voice is just so low. I'm like, what the hell? But I ain't mad at Carly because she is maximizing on her messiness, and one day I want to be like her when I grow up. Now I got Newman and Associates, where we specialize in that good tea. Like, we get that fresh brewed tea. We don't do stale tea. We get that fresh brewed tea. So I get what Carly is doing or whatever. Now they don't call me messy or whatever. I am just misinformation. Better ask somebody that knows somebody. Hello. But anyway, with that being said, I ain't mad at her for having her radio station. Like, and then off of Playboy, that's pretty damn legit. Girl, you need me on your show? So Lord Stevie J and Miss Hosaline are back up in ATL, now you and I and everybody else that's watching this all knew that Jocelyn and Stevie J weren't about to go nowhere too far. And that was cute for them to do their show. But Mona Scott was like, listen here, your damn bill's too damn high. Bring your ass on back to ATL. We're going to write a storyline. That was cute and all, and that's just what it is. That was temporary. Ain't nobody got no time to be spending that kind of money on y'all. Because I was just like, so what's happening with the show? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, they made half of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. So them going to, I mean, I got all the episodes recorded. Did anybody actually watch it, the show with them two? Was it worth it? Do I need to press my DVR and watch it? No? Really? Do I? I'm not watching it. Anyway, Jocelyn talking about she got something for everybody now.
I need everybody to come out to my show, because when I tell you the Puerto Rican princess got something for everybody, I got something for all you bitches with this $200 manicure.
I hear that Jocelyn's trying really hard to work on her English, and I commend her. God knows I do. But she had nerve enough to say that she has moved on and she's better. Bitch, you last season you was just beating the shit out of Carla Red with my 18 dozen of roses. Did you not? With her roses that she bought you. Like, girl, you ain't changed that much in one season. I keep wanting to say semester, but you ain't changed that much in one season. It was a nice ring that you rented for the show, though. Shade. I ain't got too much to say about Rashida and her fake employees. I just say one thing, bitch, fire them all, including Kirk's little disrespectful ass daughter. I would have like literally said, I need cameras, can y'all cut? I would have knocked the living shiznit out of her and she'd have been sitting there talking back to my mama like that. Like, bitch, who do you think you are? Like, it would have just been just like that. Like, I would have snap, cracker, popped on her ass, and here come Kirk twisting his ass up and start talking, well, I'm part owner of this shit. I should be here too. I'm sorry. Like, I really would love to be inside Rashida to know, like, so you don't see that twang in your man? Like, I'm not saying that he's gay, but it's just, and it could just be the way Kirk talks, but I'm just like, I don't know, but I do love Kirk. I ain't gonna lie. Like, I love Kirk and I love Rashida. I personally met them when they came out here to Houston at Club 2020 for Nisha the Diva. Hey, hey, hey. Because I actually was hosting. So let me just say that Rashida and Kirk are some of the most down-to-earth people, like, ever. Like, they weren't afraid. They weren't acting like, you know, whatever. Rashida was even up taking selfies with people. You know, Kirk and I, we may have been looking at ass together, but it was a stripper. I felt like it was, you know, for research purposes, I'm supposed to do that. As a host, I'm supposed to help him make sure he's okay and that he's looking at the right crackage of the acid. So Tiara basically feels that she should have a meeting with Scrap DeLeon and his mama. Now, this is my thing. I get the whole mother-in-law thing, you know, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I don't have any kids. I'm okay with that. Hallelujah. I got 30. Am I at 38 or 39 nieces and nephews? I am a great-great aunt before the age of 40. Thanks, guys. Appreciate you. But, yeah, I love kids, but I'm just, yeah, no. I like having my shoulder out and being able to talk to you guys and go as I please. Yeah. I may get another doggy soon, though, but other than that, no, I'm okay with kids. But anyway, this is not about me. We're going back onto the situation. If I had a child, and if I had a baby's father that helped father the child half and half, I don't necessarily agree with her antics of not letting Scrap DeLeon see his child. Like, I definitely feel that in this situation, she is definitely using that child to her advantage. There is one thing to say, I don't want my child around X, Y, and Z because they make me feel uncomfortable. That's fine. But honey, you have your own house where you can have him just as you was when you was banging him. You had no problem with that man coming up over there with that Mufasa hat, did you? No, you did not. See, Tiara, I'm about to get read on your ass, because see, what I don't like is that these women said that,
well, you can't see your baby, you can't see your baby.
Beyonce said, now you had no problem with you sitting up there hopping on that dandelion, but now that you know that Tommy and some other ugly lady is hopping on the dandelion, you got an issue where now you wanna say,
I don't feel comfortable, I don't feel safe.
Bitch, sit down somewhere. Let that man see his child. It makes me mad women like you that sit up there and try to keep that child away from that man when he is trying to be a father. Then the minute that he's not trying to be a father, he like deuce on your ass and,
oh my God, he's just like the rest of these black men that don't want to take a child to, you know, have like something with their child.
Stop. Now I get what you was trying to come through, but now I feel like now you're just trying to use that baby as a tool. Not cool. Not cool at all. Mm-mm. Some of y'all may not agree with me. I don't really give any of all of no fucks. I really don't care. You're right. Trinity, you don't have no kids. Bitch, you're right. I don't. But I can voice my opinion, and that is my opinion, and I choose to stick with it. My opinion is that child has a father that has a father that actually wants to be in his life. If you want to monitor the visits, that's fine. Allow that. But I'm with Scrappy's mama. Bitch, you don't want to let him see his child. Well, let's get the white people. It's like, y'all see, I got my hair. I miss my hair. I really don't, but that's my hair. So when I do this, understand it, bitch. I'm flipping it behind my ear and I'm whipping it. But no, seriously, like, I don't know. That just was like to my soul. I don't like that. Like, do not, like, he had a point. The kids are innocent. Now, he's a hoe. You knew he was a hoe when you met him. You knew he was a hoe when you was banging him. Now, I get being blindsided and all that stuff. But at the end of the day, like, don't make the child pay for the hoe ass mistakes of the parents. Like, do not let the parent, let the kids suffer for BS that's going on with the parents. That's stupid. Don't do that shit. That scene with you and Carly Rae, that makeup, I don't know if it was horrorous or what you was going for, a reversal, beat down, cat eye, I don't know, but it looked like you literally was like, and put your makeup on. It was god awfully terrible. Like, you done had your makeup beat several times to where I'm pretty sure you know how to do them. Goddamn eyebrows was too damn thick. They were making me nervous. I felt like you was just pretty much like this the whole time. And that damn, that eye thing, I don't know if that was an extended. I'm mad at everybody. Cat eye, and I got tea cat eye. I don't know what it was, but I didn't like it. But she's sitting there, and I'm like, she's dramatically sipping on this tea or whatever. And Carly Rae is just like,
I mean, Jasmine, I miss you so much. Like, I mean, I know you beat the shit out of me with some roses, but like, can we just be friends?
Jasmine's pretty much like,
oh, honey, I just came to tell you I got tea on your ass.
Like, I want to know what's on the, in that envelope or whatever. And what was that spazzing thing that Carly Rae did? She, bitch. What is, and I was like, oh, that's that Carly Rae. Oh, y'all remember her? Like, she's done that before. Like, yeah, not surprised at all. Is it me or every time y'all see Dom, does she look like Baps? Like, I automatically think of Halle Berry and Baps every time I see her with that pink ass Mufasa boom boom bang bang wig on. I'm like, I see Baps. All I need you to do is have two gold teeth, you know, and just be like, booyah, and then say it in the back of your head. And I feel like I'm watching Babs again. But she's playing Peacemaker, make me a match with Mimi and Tiara. And so it was funny because I'm with Mimi. I'd have been like, nah, get this biatch out of here. But, you know, I'm not gonna lie, Tiara is a little cute little melanin little thing, girl. She walked in there, but I was like, does she have braces? Because it's like, I just feel like there's something over her teeth. So it makes me, she's talking like she has braces. So I'm gonna make my assumption to say that she, I can't remember her smiling. Cause it's like, it's always over, or it's like, you know, when people have braces, like, they kind of talk, oh, and that top lip just really don't move because they don't want to cut that shit on braces. I heard about that. Like, I get it. I had worn Invisalign. That's what happened when my gap had disappeared. You know, so I never had the experience of having the metal in my mouth, but Jesus, if that's what's going on with them, she's still cute. But I'm glad that she got a little bit of advice, but I hope that her advice didn't backfire on her with the whole situation. I don't know. We'll see. Why is everybody's reaction the exact same about Mimi having a girlfriend? Everybody's like, bitch, girl, Mimi don't know what she want. Like, Mimi, girl, why you letting these people talk about you like that? Is that the truth about you? Like, you just, I guess, kind of, sort of, like, you literally went, we done seen you in 3 relationships. I wonder if she just kind of seeking, because that whole thing with Stevie J just really bothered her more than she let on. I can definitely see that as being the case, because you get to a point where you have something in your mind and then everything just disappears and you just kind of almost kind of get lost to where you're seeking. And unfortunately, she is seeking herself and what she loves and what she cares about on national TV. And so unfortunately, that gives people room to judge. That's kind of the price you pay when you unfortunately, you know, live your life in the public. Just gotta take the bad with the good, bitch. Y'all, Scrappy is such a male thought. Like, did y'all see how he was looking at that model? He was like, I'm like, you can't even concentrate with, like, being a real manager or whatever you're supposed to be because you too busy looking at ass. I don't know. Now, this is my take on the whole situation. I get being there for Scrappy, but I felt like Scrappy was a little selfish to even expect Rashida to get in the middle of that, especially since Rashida is friends with Erica. Speaking of Erica, where the hell is she? Why did she get off the show? Did she get another boyfriend? I can't remember, like, the whole reason why she got off the show, if they actually kicked off, and it was pretty much like them jobs where they were like, you could save face and quit, you know, but, I mean, either you quit or we gonna fire you, but you ain't got no job after today. So I don't know if it was one of them things where she was like, well, I quit. You know, but Mona was really like, no, bitch, you fired. Now, this is the thing with Scrap DeLeon's mom. I feel that Karen has every right to be mad at Tiara if she feels that Tiara was the reason why she went to jail or whatever, whatever. But at the end of the day, if your ass was doing a crime, aren't you the one that's supposed to be doing the time now? I don't believe in snitching, you know, but, like, how you gonna get mad at somebody if it's, like, them or you, and then, like, they may say something or whatever, and then now, oh, bitch, you know, you fake. Bitch, you were the ones up there writing checks and doing all this illegal stuff. What you want me to do? Bitch, I got a life. I got a job. I got 17 jobs trying to take care of one kid. That's kind of what she was saying. I don't know. I don't know about that one. I would feel some type of way. I would feel betrayed, but I don't know. I would still kind of put stuff to the side. Like, I'd be like, bitch, I'm watching you. Like, I mean, I get it, you know, like, after a while, you got to forgive people, you know, but I'm like, because that's on you. You know, you having that, you harboring that energy or whatever, that's on you. It ain't got nothing to do with somebody. You sit up there wasting valuable energy, being mad at X, Y, and Z, being sitting out somewhere. Is my battery low? What? Oh, it's something about to happen. Let me hurry up. Yeah, so anyway, I plan to keep this up and keep, you know, reviewing the show or whatever. If you guys want me to, make sure you thumb up this video or whatever. I'm excited to see about this next episode because this is when the party is happening where Jocelyn has invited all of Atlanta, all of its messiness to this party. So it's about to be on. Anyway, someone loves, this episode is definitely long enough. Did y'all notice that it's a whole bunch of tea that's going on? Did y'all especially notice that Jocelyn had the nerve enough to ask Mimi if that her tongue action was better than Chris's? Jesus! Woo. Chris's face was freaking priceless. Anyway, sucker mother lovers, as always, this video is definitely long enough. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, bitch, I'm out.
Lord, I live for all the messiness of love and hip-hop Atlanta, bitch. Now let me go read a book.